Hey guys, welcome to another Patreon video. One of my longtime supporters, Jesse Miller, had some hours saved up and had an idea, which is that he wanted to see what happens in Firewatch if you play through the entire game just not talking to Delilah on the walkie-talkie. So the idea here is I'm going to play through the entire game and I'm just going to not talk, unless the game absolutely requires me to do so to proceed. And we'll see how that goes. If you want to find out how to sponsor videos and tell me what to play and stuff like that, check out patreon.com/SebastianSB. Like always, the link is always in the description. Let's get started. Oh, cool. It actually keeps track of your saves. Alright. By the way, just for credit, For context, this is a cool game. So if you have not experienced it at all, I recommend checking it out yourself, because you can only really experience it for the first time once. Otherwise, if you haven't seen my other playthrough, go ahead and check the description. And you can find my entire... There's a whole playlist for my original playthrough of this game where I was playing it naturally, the way, which is more or less how this is intended to be, is you respond the way you want to. This is sort of like a challenge run, with no difficulty, of course, but I'm doing a special run here of, let's follow a specific rule the entire playthrough. And it's a fun experiment when you already know the game, but it's probably not the best way to experience the story for the first time. So I'm just pre-warning you now to check out my other playlist or play it yourself. Let's get started. You see Julia. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You are drunk.
You're pretty.
You're pretty, she says, coolly. You are not. You are a future hangover. What? You reply, confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. She flags down a waiter, and 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. Hello, elevator. Alright, let's load up then. I always found it interesting that this game starts out as being practically a Twine game. Well, it's interspersed with these scenes of you starting your job and heading out, but it's funny how it's sort of this the way that they handle these visual novels, like the way I did when I played the game. This book is a dungeon. I didn't close the back, did I? You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in. You share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about everywhere. Anywhere, life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia's in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. I think last time we got Bucket, so let's you adopt the shepherd and name him Mayhem. Because German shepherds are awesome. Mayhem's an excellent dog. He loves wrestling with you in the park and goes with Julia on her runs. Even though he's too big to bring to school, Julia loves him all the same. Mayhem is a friend, child, and pet all rolled into one. I want a German Shepherd. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m., and the heat still radiates off you, off the high desert. What do you think about kids, she asks. Kids? They're not very smart, or good at much. I'm saying, if you and I have some, a couple of idiots. One day, why rush? She looks away, out towards the mountains. We have plenty of time, right? Speak for yourself, mister. Don't worry, you assure her. You tell her she has the body of an undergrad. My ovaries didn't get the memo, she said, laughing it off. One day, okay? Okay, one day, she says. 6 months later, you get engaged, lying in bed on a Sunday morning. And here's our big warning that something went wrong. They're switching between story of that and then scenes of us being in the middle of nowhere. I'm gonna do something special this playthrough. I disabled the map. Oh, the map works because you can look at this piece of paper as a map. Can I open the map right here? That's just a compass. Normally it shows you where you are on the map. I'm just gonna play it by navigating myself. Granted, I'm cheating a bit because I've already seen the environment at this point. I already know some of the layout based on whatever I can remember from a few months ago. Still is a beautiful game. If Brutal Legend was walking through a metal album, then this game is walking through a postcard. 1980. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You ignore her. You don't touch each other all night. The next day you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She says it was great. You hold on to a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. You frolic like a Victoria's Secret model. Julia was right. You are very pretty. Onwards. It really is a beautiful game. Everything's set up to high or ultra right now. This game apparently has performance problems on the PlayStation 4 and has, low density in its, environments, so it looks less like a proper forest. It's a really rare case where you actually get a very observably worse experience by playing it on console. Two Forks Lookout Tower. They apparently had to really reduce the density of the assets, which is kind of a bummer. Just look at this. It's nice. 1982. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking mayhem at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Mayhem runs away. Fucked dog? Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker. And you scare him away? You reach into your pocket like you got a gun and threaten to kill him. You manage to scare all three of you. He runs away. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. Well, that's a bummer. Mayhem ran away. Do we just not have a dog now? So much for the whole thing is where they set up the tough dog and then the mugging from the first playthrough, and I had the little dumb dog. I thought that maybe the tough dog was going to help, but he doesn't. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Enjoy your idiocracy. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Convince her not to take the job. You tell her that this means you two won't have a family. She says that's bullshit. She's totally right. She asks if her taking the job means you won't come with her. You say yes, again, bullshit. And she decides not to take it. Well, that's dark. 1985. Julia's asked to leave Boulder on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to her just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. You make macaroni and drink wine and try to forget about it. It works. You watch Dallas on TV and sleep together on the couch. Well, obviously I'm picking a lot of the opposite choices I did last time, as best as I can remember, just to see what impact it has. Let's see our drawing. There's our Victoria's Secret model mode moment. Mayhem is getting older. He's got silver hair down his back and slows down at night. You and Julia walk him to the bar to see your friends, and it feels like nothing has changed. Julia goes back to the university. I'm surprised Mayhem's still around. I wasn't sure if that was going to be the case. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days, you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn child little idiots. On other days, you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family. They are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple months. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility. Wife is going crazy slowly and surely, and there's no fixing it. Because young people can lose their minds too. Basically, the worst thing that a lot of people can think of is the idea of just losing who you are and not being able to control it. That first leap looked really strange. Her family agrees with your decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day. Then every other day. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, "If you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I will cut your balls off." You slowly decide not to see your old friends that much. Julia's sister, Susan, moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. You've always really liked Susan. Months go by. Mayhem dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more, you think. Summer's coming, and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. And here we are, presumably. It's a little dark. The way that the story contextualizes it this time is that one of the last thoughts that he has is that the more he doesn't see Julia, the more that she just completely forgets who I am. And, our response is then to go on a trip where aren't going to be visiting for like 3 months. Pretty much guaranteeing, if that theory is correct, that she's just going to forget who we are forever. Which is a much darker outlook than we had the first time around from the other choices. Granted, we were seeing her even less when she was in a different country. Hello. It's good to be back, isn't it? Oh, we don't have any power? Nope. Just gotta remind myself how this whole part works, huh? Was that it? Yep, never mind. No big deal.
Hello, Two Forks Tower.
Nope. It's mandatory for this part, isn't it?
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
And now we wait, because there's a progress meter. He already sounds really dismissive and annoyed. I don't know if that happened last time. So maybe it's decided by the decisions I made up to now.
You're just gonna wait me out on this? Ugh, fine. But I'm gonna take a second here and have a guess about you. Let's see. I don't know anything about you. But maybe you just really like trees. Maybe it's... Gosh, maybe it's a borderline fetish. A tree fetish.
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job.
And so it begins. A long trip of trying to ignore this woman as much as possible.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
We have to this time, right? I think we have to talk to her because we don't even have our job set up yet of where we go. I don't know, I could try. No, I can't go out the door yet.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
I know which way is west.
Are those fucking fireworks?
Are they? I mean, I know they are, but yep, they're there. Can I just leave?
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Damn it. All right.
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight.
I imagine we'll probably have to talk to her whenever important story stuff happens, but otherwise, as we walk around, we can keep going. Boop-boop-boo. Here we go.
I'm sorry it's not in the job description. Look, just go down there, okay? Make sure they stop with this shit. Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Alright, let's take a look at our map then. So here's Two Forks. We're going off towards Jonesy Lake-ish. Let's see. There's the cache. 306. So we're going to want to head northwest along this path, really. Cache box 306. I'm slightly worried I'll mess this up somehow. I'm trying to get around. We'll see how it goes. You can put down the compass now. Oh, is that what shift does? That is what shift does. How do I run? Oh no, I've forgotten how to run. I'll just look it up real quick, I guess. Do-do-do controls. Isn't there a move faster button? R. Okay. Yeah, because there we go. My bad. I kept trying to run by popping out with the, radio. I'm sure it was a problem last time, was trying to pop out the radio all the time. Alright, here's our supply box. Hello. One, two, three, four. That's the worst code. Alright. You are mine now. What's the keep button? Hold E. We've been through these before, so we don't need to obsess over some of those as much. Might as well keep our notes. Bam, we have map notes. Alright. That granola bar is mine. Thank you. Just gonna be kind of a scumbag this whole playthrough if I can. Pine cone, get out of here. You live there now. Alright. Off we go. I'm gonna keep doing that, just like last time, I think. Alright. So we're at 306, so we want to go slightly more southwest, but mostly west. Which is this path right here. Map navigation. This will be fun. I've heard that it's actually a good experience to play this game without having the thing telling you where you're currently located. I didn't know that was even a setting when I first played it. It's weird that the game doesn't ask you if you want to have that turned on or off by default. Because it just defaults to on, and a lot of people have said the best experience is to have it turned off. But I wouldn't know that because I intentionally try not to spoil my stuff about games, so I'm not looking for press or opinions about the game before I play it. Here we go. Nope, I'm not here. I'm not going to tell her that the shale is steep. She's going to go on a nice, peaceful, silent adventure. The funny thing is that if she's talking to me less, this is actually going to be a easier to edit video.
No!
Good start. Ow. Well, we still got everything. There we go. She doesn't react because we weren't in the middle of a call this time. You could report it if you're a bitch. I'm joking. A climbing location actually has a little climbing drawing on it. Are those anywhere else? I think those get added as you go. I don't remember that being there before. Maybe I never had a reason to look at it up close. Anyway, we're still continuing forward. I'm still gonna keep popping out the walkie-talkie. I imagine this will be a faster playthrough than the last one was, because I probably won't be pausing to do conversations constantly, or reading notes that we've already read in our previous playthrough. Instead, we could just do observations, but silently. Like these goddamn beer cans. I gotta clean up, right? I am a good park ranger. I'm actually cleaning up more now than I did last time. I think it took me a while to even find that feature. Goddamn kids, ruined the world. Can I just take their supplies? That'd be fun. Just, these are mine now. Hello. Those are mine now. Those are my rockets.
Oh shit, ferret or Irish.
Yummy, yummy. I'm gonna get in trouble for that, aren't I? Welcome back, alcoholism. We're gonna have a great time. Yep, and they went skinny dipping. You can go a surprisingly long time without talking to her, can't you? I was pausing to have so many conversations along the way here. Hello? There they are. Hey, kids!
Cool stereo!
Whoa, hey! Put that down! You asshole!
Light another firework and it won't be your stereo I wreck!
Oh, fuck you, psycho!
Yeah, fuck you!
You'll fucking pay for this! You can't just harass girls in the woods! Let's get out of here!
Bye! Ooh, what's that sound? I'm hearing noises over here.
Hey, that go okay?
Just gonna keep not responding, that's great. I just come across as like a massive asshole so far. A massive asshole.
You there, Henry?
What was that? Oh, trail sign.
Well, look, if you can hear me, try to get back soon, okay? It's getting late.
I'm admittedly trying to find the turtle. I thought they might be here, but I'm not sure. There's a turtle in this game. It was in the preview, and I never found it the first time around. I don't know where it is. Oh, well. There's a bunch of sounds coming from over here. which is why I thought I might be over here. I can't quite identify that sound properly. Oh well. Delilah's... Henry just... It's funny how just ignoring dialogue here and there and being a dick with the radio, like, totally recontextualized. It's like, so far, the Henry we have in this game is a completely different person from the Henry we had in our last playthrough. Like, he comes across completely differently. I'm sure that the story probably plays out the same, ultimately, as far as, like, the actual beats along the way. Especially due to the nature of how the story works and how elements of it happened before the game even started, technically. But, I don't know. This seems like it might be one of those cases where someone would be like, where the internet at large would complain about how this game doesn't, your choices don't matter because nothing changes when you change what you do and so on and so forth.
So, I have a bit of a confession to make.
But those people don't seem to understand that, like, when you change the structure of a story, like, these different pieces of dialogue recontextualize my character in major ways. Just gonna ignore her confession. I get the feeling she's gonna power through it, though. No? She's not saying anything. Alright. That's a bit of a surprise. Nope, storming. Shit. And then was the moment where Henry realized for the first time we're stuck. Outside. What will we do? It's a beautiful game. I want to visit this place, even though it's not real. Hello? Doop-boop-boo. It's interesting to view all of the dialogue in the game as optional. Because in many ways, it is the game. But you don't have to constantly do it. I can't keep this with me? That's a bummer. Nope. Should I grab the flashlight real quick? Good job. Copy down a few more notes. There we go. There was nothing else in there, right? Yeah. This antler's mine, and I'm keeping it. You can't tell me otherwise. Here we go. Welcome to the spooky cave. The spooky, plot important for later cave. It's a good thing we set it up here. Aw, I can't take it with me. That didn't work out. Well, at least now it's on the ground where I can, like, fall on it later. That'll work out well for me. How did I toggle the flashlight when I was climbing? Both my hands were occupied. And suddenly nighttime. Well, sort of nighttime. They very specifically used the cave as the to hide- Ooh, all those trees just loaded in all at once. They cleverly used the cave to hide that sky- that, the time of day transition. So you wouldn't see it in real time. Hey, buddy. How you doing? That's probably the father. The fire watchman that was just kind of hanging out around here originally. And, disappeared. For reasons that we now know if you've seen the previous playthrough. And I'm edging around the idea of spoiling it as if it's, like, this is... I should just continue to assume that everyone watching this has already knows the story of this game, because otherwise this is the wrong way to experience it. Upward! Wow, this is going to be a short playthrough, I think. I'm just thinking about how fast we're proceeding through this. I think the game took me like 4.5 hours to play, doing all the dialogue and reading a bunch of notes along the way, so this one's at a... This one's probably going to be a lot more brief. We'll see how it goes. The downside of not having to talking to Delilah all the time is I don't know what I'm going to talk about. As a commentator. It'll be interesting. I wonder if she gets creepy. I want to know if she because she's isolated out here, if she'll just start talking to me constantly and can't stop or something. Whoopsie. Nailed it.
Damn it.
Did it. I think there was an alternate path that I didn't take. Was there? Let's see here. Oh yeah, there was a split path. Kind of forgot about that. Could have done that, I guess. That's about as minor as details probably get, though. I'm grabbing this damn thing and taking it with me. You live with me now, creepy forest man. You're coming with me. Did they already... Oh yeah, they already broke... I already got broken into, didn't I? Even though it's the beginning of the game. That was loud. Dramatic music cue. What the fuck? What'd you do? You broke into my house. What's wrong with you? You live here now, Forest Burns. There we go. This is where you are now. They broke my window. I volunteer as a lookout. I volunteer as tribute. That's just a random raccoon picture. So, someone broke into my window. Being a dick. It was very unlikely to be the little girls, because they wouldn't have found this location that fast. So it was probably, you know who. In fact, I think we already confirmed that it was the previous watchman. You fucked up my books. Excuse me? Incredibly rude. I just organized these, damn it. It's the first thing I did when I got here. Oops, sorry, book. There we go. That's fine. I'm just gonna continue to be the better man here. There we go. The birds of Wyoming. Welcome home, Forest Burns. I think I have to report the broken window, though, to continue. I'm not sure. Wonder, will it show my objective? Yep, report vandalism. That's the objective.
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
Oopsie, I forgot about the typewriter. Let's go get that. Typewriter, I'm sorry. Forgot about you. I need you. You're like my counseling. You're from Julia's sister. Which my character seems to like.
Okay, I put in a call.
Making me wonder if they had some kind of fling that we don't know about, which makes this whole thing even more questionable in some ways. Alright. And we wait.
Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Oh, we gonna have fun.
I can't believe someone would do this. I mean, I worry about bears and fires and that's about it, and now I've got to worry about who knows what out there. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here. Anyway, I hope you can sleep. I'll talk to you in the morning.
Definitely a little amusing how she'll just keep talking after a while. Just power through that awkwardness.
Wake up! Hey, wake up!
I'm sure I'm not even allowed to leave the radio, right? I don't have anything to do yet, so I probably have to respond. Unless I can just go ahead outside. Like, screw it. I'm going out here now. It's where I live. Hey, the card. That's funny. The plywood stand-up of the man is still here. That's a nice little touch. And I believe the note I collected is probably somewhere around here. Yeah. So you can sort of collect things along the way, and they all kind of show up. All right. Let's work on our repairs of this place. While I try to ignore my neighbor.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case. I mean, we've had issues with the radios going out in this area before. Anyway, I'm sending all the lookouts out to check the wire in their areas. Yours is a good hike away. If you find any portion of it down, I can try to get a hold of a ranger and he'll bring someone in to fix it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
You probably had to hike through a cave yesterday to get home.
Yeah, I did.
So you're going to want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
That's a funny little touch. She's like, you probably saw a cave. Because she didn't see it, because we never talked to her about the cave, so she's like, yeah, you probably walked through a cave on your way back. Possibly. Because the way you got stuck on the way around. So we're trying to go north. Am I going the wrong way at all? Can I not go past this thing? Maybe I can just walk around it? Yeah, there we go. We need to find the entrance to this cave. Don't think you can go that way. Yeah, they've actually had to recontextualize the dialogue there so that she can't talk about the cave that we went through last time for sure, because I didn't call in on her and play a prank about getting in trouble or anything like that. Should probably keep my compass out to make sure I'm going where I think I am. How did I mess this up? Should I somehow mess this up? I'm probably too far over to the west than I should be. Let's head back here a little bit. It's probably on the other side of this rock. Can I go around this thing, please? Yes, okay. I was worried I might have to turn around and go back around. Let's see, let's try this side of the outcrop. This looks promising. Yep. There's the path. Okay, so it looks like if there was a split in the path, it was probably past here. Yeah, so I guess no matter what I did, I was going to knock over that sign. That part's irrelevant. That is a hell of a drop to just do casually. If you're going to be here every day for a while, it just seems like you're going to really screw with your joints and so on by doing that over and over again. Just seems like an all-around bad call. Well, who am I to tell Hank how to live, besides the fact that I've chosen a series of dialogue options that seems to make him a shittier person? Hardcore parkour. Got it. He's still wearing his ring. I wonder if you can make a series of decisions that would lead to him taking off his ring out of shame or something. I don't think it'll be this playthrough, because I think I'm not... I doubt that if I'm going to get any warmer to Delilah than I have in the past. Unless she's just really into silent people. Alright, so we want to keep heading up here towards Cache 302. Because somewhere along there is where we're going to find the communication line and where it has been interrupted. Hello, cave. Hey, the antler's still here. That's a nice touch. It actually remembers where you put each individual little piece along the way. Can I get this through the gate? Not quite. Alright. Too bad I can't put the antler in my backpack to take it with me. You know, when you go to this place totally silently, instead of with a teammate, I mean, instead of without her talking to you all the time, it kind of makes this whole thing feel just a little bit more survival horror-y. Like, talking to her all the time distracted you from the isolation element, which was kind of the point. Because you're out here and you're alone, and you're here for 3 months, you would want to talk to somebody all the time on the radio. Just to have contact with somebody, because otherwise there's nothing. And by choosing not to talk to her as much as I can, the isolation sets in. Start thinking about whether or not there's going to be like a moose or a bear coming out around the corner. And just all around ruining you, basically. Hello? Isn't the porta potty somewhere around here? With the poetry? Is that you? Old outhouse. Excuse me? You're mine? Now you're my bad poetry. Can you open the toilet? Nope. Alright, let's go inside that house, because last time I didn't. I don't really have an excuse, I just didn't open it for some reason. Oh, there's a cache. I walked up to it, and for some reason I thought I couldn't. I don't know why I thought that. Is it 1, 2, 3, 4 or 4, 3, 2, 1? I think it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I briefly second guessed it for some reason. Hat? You're my hat now. Bloop. Impersonating a soldier. Good job. Hello, cabin. The door just falls right off. This seems safe. Ruined firefinder. Cigarette boxes. Not usable, apparently, or even grabbable. And it's just a collapsed little cliff here. Can I go down the stairs? Oh yeah, there's a whole area. That's a guitar. Look at that. Well, you can't look at it very closely, apparently. It's not actually a very useful way of looking at it. Take that, guitar. That was an oddly violent animation for opening that. Alright. Not a lot going on here besides the little guitar touch. Can't play it or take... I can take it with me, I guess. Onwards. Or I could throw it off the ledge. Maybe I'll just take the guitar with me? It lets me run while I'm holding the guitar. You can place it somewhere memorable. Alright. I can't take out my compass while I'm in this view. I think I'm going the right way. Maybe not. There's one way to know. Alright, so we're trying to go up here. We want to head north, which is that way. Got it. Oh, did you make me drop it? Oh, you didn't. Cool, this guitar's mine now. I'm keeping it. I will name it George, and it will be my companion, because I'm not talking to Delilah ever, apparently. It'll be the Wilson of this trip. This one-string guitar. The equivalent of playing dental floss as an instrument. There's one of our supply caches we can visit. So we're getting close then. I remember this location. What an awkward position to hold the guitar in, by the way, when you're actually jogging through the woods. Just holding it in front of you the whole time. It would not exactly be my choice. But, oops. I flipped it over. But they always have to insist on doing the whole first-person shooter thing where your character, like some kind of idiot, holds everything they ever encounter directly in front of their faces. If you ever want to get a good laugh out of something, just try to reenact a first-person shooter you've seen before. And just, like, look at the way that the character holds basic items and stuff. And try to set up, set up a camera, like a... I don't know, freaking tie a phone to your face or whatever, and just try to recreate the imagery, because people just hold stuff super strangely in first-person shooters, because normally things you're holding in your hands just don't fit your field of view, like, ever. So to make it so that you constantly can see everything you're holding, they just have to just... they basically have to impede themselves with how they're holding items. And this is a good example. I'm holding a guitar. How does this camera angle work? Yep, that guitar is inside my gut. If you look down while running, it just enters the inside of your body. Did I make it? Aw. Guitar, come with me. I did it. Get out of here, beer cans. I need my guitar. This is a love you'll never understand. Oh no, don't drop it. Yes, I magically have guitar. It is mine now. And there's the line. Oop. Beer cans. Do-do-do-do. Pick it up. Oh, I can't? Oh, that one's inside of a rock. Alright, these beer cans are just defying all of time and space, so I'm going to refuse to pick them up now. On the grounds that I don't have hazard pay for temporal vortexes. So we're gonna ignore that. There's actually originally a teaser scene if you watch the trailer for this game, you're up on this ledge checking out the wire being cut, and then you're like, wait, you're not in your tower right now? Then who is? Dun, dun, dun! And you look over there, and someone's in your tower. But, that actually doesn't happen in the game that way. It happens totally differently. It reminds me of how in Kung Fu Panda, they use the word skadoosh at some point. But if you watch the trailer that originally told you that line, and then you watch the movie, the line's in a totally different part of the film, which is interesting to me. I think I have to report the wire.
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it.
That's actually good to hear. I can send someone out to fix it. Good find.
Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately. It's snipped clean through, and there's a bunch of beer cans out here. The same beer those girls were drinking. They also left us a message.
These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Hmm. Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
All right, so that entire conversation didn't happen last time, really. I mean, the part about the cut wire did, but I don't think Delilah ever suggested wrecking their camp. I wonder if that was because of the fact that I literally picked up their radio and threw it into the water the last time. But she doesn't know about that, because she wasn't even in part of that call. She just suddenly heard from me saying that my stuff was wrecked. And that was about it. I'm keeping this guitar, dammit. I'm keeping it, and it's mine. So we want to make our way down south. Because they're down there somewhere. See, that's my way of getting further north. Yep. I actually don't fully remember where the fire was that they have. You want to find where they lit their fire. Hello. I swipe.
Eh.
There we go. Just bat at it for a second. Ah. There we go. There's our camera. We can start taking pictures now.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. Just found an old pack full of them. In decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
And good story, bro. We're gonna stop talking now. Pachoom!
Anyway, this guitar. Yeah, Brian Goodwin.
This guitar's gonna
he
get stuck somewhere.
He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. It took off halfway through the summer.
Well, he was a great kid. Oh, there's the fire. Found it. Nope. No talking.
Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Boop. There's our picture. We should pose the guitar. Did it. Hit. Land face up, damn it. There we go. Should I make an album cover or something? You are to be loved and remembered, broken guitar. There we go. I'm gonna try to remember to take a full camera roll so that we can actually have photos to remember when I develop the film later. There we go. So we're on our way towards the fire, which Delilah doesn't know about, because I'm not telling her. The end. We just need to head along this way. I wonder how long I can keep this guitar. I could take it back to my base, I think.
So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker. For 15 years. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
Wow. I don't think I've heard that conversation before. Go! I believe in you, guitar.
I guess I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
That's fine, have fun.
Anyway, a few thinly veiled threats should be all it takes to get us back up and running. Guy's a pushover.
No, I quit. I don't think I'm getting it out of that. I think it got stuck inside the world. That is a part of the game that is not designed to have objects colliding with it. We'll see, maybe it'll get pushed down by me walking. That doesn't bode well. Nope, I think it literally fell through the world, unfortunately. Ah. It's up there. Wait, I can almost walk up there. Oh, I can see the guitar sticking out. No. Sadness. Oh, now I'm stuck. Uh-oh. Okay, let's continue on before this gets more problematic. I think the rope's glitching around a little bit while colliding with part of the guitar up there. There's a few messes to deal with here. Alright, well, my fascination with that guitar is over with, so I guess we'll have to find a new toy to just run around with. It's a good thing I took a photo to remember the situation before we moved on. So as we, at some point we listened to the, we read the psychological profiles of our characters that we also know are fake now, from the previous, fire watchmen or whatever we want to call them.
Hey, do you see that? I think I just spotted something. I can barely make it out, but there's a small wisp of smoke way down to the southwest. You should be able to find a way over there from the meadow by the lake. Towards Five Mile Creek, it's in the southwest quadrant of your map.
She kind of just keeps going. Alright, yep, there's the wisp of smoke. I was already on my way. More or less. So we read the profiles on our characters, and the weird thing is that hers seemed to indicate that she has a different take on relationships, and that she seems to even have a weird inability to process that she's currently in a relationship. Like, I forgot the boyfriend's name, but she has some sort of active boyfriend who she's never actually broken.
You know, if it makes you feel any better, you're a member of a diverse club of lookouts that have come to the thoroughfare after a breakup. I mean, I assume you went through a breakup. At least that's my best guess at this stage. There was Vernon, whose wife got put away for running cocaine. Becca, who was widowed after her husband, a jockey, was trampled by his horse. And Sharon, whose boyfriend had his own boyfriend. Maybe you boned the neighbor. Maybe she boned the neighbor. Maybe you both did. I don't judge. And if you ever want to talk breakups, I'm your gal.
She is all about the gossip. Nope, there it goes. Yeah, she was, the implication was that she, what I think it was that she wasn't properly broken up with her boyfriend, but just acting like he didn't exist, basically. Like, she has a weird way of dealing with relationships in general. Because I don't think, I'm trying to remember, but I don't think she mentions him a single time, but I think Ned knows about him, and there's even, like, documentation to refer to them knowing that they exist. But, like, I guess she doesn't, but, like, the boyfriend doesn't know that she's even here or something. So it brings a few things to light when she's sitting here talking about how she'd rather spend a night with Sonny Bono than 40 years with a cheating stockbroker. She has a very open view at relationships in general, and is probably not very good wife material, in that she probably won't really care too much in the long term about the marriage. So we're looking for oh no, did I just go down that? Ah, it's circled, so I think that is that still where we're going? Yes, yeah, it says campfire smoke. That's handy. There's the medicine wheel. There's a few notes around here. We've actually covered, over the course of this episode, we started here, went all the way to the top of the entire map, and now we're going down to the bottom corner of the map. So interestingly, not episode, over the course of this day has you walk across the entire diagonal length of the map that this game has. Probably in an attempt to make you feel really early on that the place is huge. But then, of course, you're looking at a map, so it's pretty easy to observe the fact that that's the entire map. I'm gonna feel really silly if I've walked past anything, but I think the wisp of smoke should be over there somewhere. In all the light. Give me a new obsessive item, come on. After that tragedy guitar. I need a fix, man. Alright, sketching away. He's really good at pointing a pencil at something and actually getting results out of that. Get out of your pine cones, you don't belong here. Who's been collecting pine cones is what I want to know. This place is beautiful. The lush woods, look at those sunbeams. The god rays. Fantastic. Anything over here? Hello. We've got our turtle. I found him. You are mine now. I adopt you. You will be mayhem too. There we go. I was wondering where the hell that turtle was. Thought he was by the pond for some reason. Maybe he changes direct locations, or maybe there's several of him. Now we have a pet turtle to keep us company. He's my new obsession now that we have lost our other thing. Our guitar. Alright. There's the scrap of fabric. That's always a bad sign. It's a really bad piece of evidence that, I trashed their stereo, and then she was telling me to trash their camp. But then look here. Now their camp is trashed. Without me doing anything. But since Ned is... his name's Ned, right? Has been recording our conversations, now he knows everything. And now we're in deep shit, is what we are. Yep, that's not good. I believe we have to report that, though.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
The girls?
I found their campsite. Someone or something tore it to shreds, and the girls left me a note behind.
Well, what's it say? Hello? Henry, are you there? Honestly, I'm just glad they're gone. It's probably the best case scenario for us, and now we can just get back to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Of course, now we know nothing happens to the girls, they're totally fine. They just are off being dumb girls for a while. Now we're fixing the window. Why did we take a whole day off from doing that? That was a weird call to not fix the window for an entire 24-hour period. You think it would bother me that there was a gaping
Henry.
Hole in the place I live in?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Well, you're gonna have to stay that way. I wonder what she'll draw if she doesn't know what I look like.
This isn't that hard.
How do you know?
Unless you just don't want to answer.
You don't know how hard I am.
In which case, I'm going to say that you are lopsided like the Hunchback and, ooh, hairy like the man in the Iron Mask. Take that. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
He is not having any of her bullshit right now. He's not pleased.
Now this can't be that hard. Think of your closet. Open it in your mind. What is inside?
Must straighten books.
I'm guessing nothing but really gross bowling shirts. Congratulations. At least tell me about your face.
You live on map. You are king of this world.
Be free!
That is a horrifying thing to do to a turtle. Look at the little guy go.
Come on, you're no fun.
Sorry.
Okay, I'll try one last one. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
You're what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm going to do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Kind of horrifying how you treat this turtle. You're mine now. You go in my
just
pocket.
Just gonna make it up, and because I'm nice, you won't look too disfigured. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Oh, and that window is all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and, I'll give it to you.
You're my new pet now. That's not how this works. Alright, I'll keep you around, alcoholism.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through. It seems like you're having some doubts. Why don't you hike around for a bit and let me know when you're ready?
Okay, now I'm ready. Let's get to work.
How were those precious few seconds of jobless freedom?
Oh, magical.
Good. Now get to work. Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
I'm having a sandwich. You shut your mouth. This is me time. Go away. This is my sunset sandwich.
Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
And the last person to see the radio.
And this turtle. And the sandwich.
Well, it's a big if. It might not be them. Look, it's not going to be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
With all those one-sided conversations she's having, she's just made for YouTube. She could do it. She's got to put her mind to it.
I'm gonna take your silence as maybe we just don't say anything. All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Meanwhile, Henry already threw away the radio and isn't even listening to her anymore. And she's just literally talking to no one.
Henry. Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
Of course, Burns, you live here forever. And Turtle.
Oh, I could never send you away. Take me back.
Turtle, I love you. Come to me. Okay, Forrest Burns, you're freaking out. Go have a drink. There you go.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
I'm not talking to you. You called me an idiot.
I'm sorry to wake you up.
No, you're not.
Are you having a nice time?
Don't you have, like, dying to get to? Mentally handicapped person?
Henry? Are you having a nice time?
I'm a monster.
You just must be so tired. I'm sorry. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Bye, baby.
Weird, I was perfectly coherent when I picked up the turtle. But I was all deranged and exhausted sounding on the radio. Maybe they didn't script the turtle for this.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Wow, just dumping your baggage on me, aren't you, lady? Not getting weird at all. All
hey,
right.
So, who's Jules? I mean, I assume it's your ex.
Nope, not falling for it. Get out of my business.
I don't mean to pry.
Yes, you
it's
do.
Just, Well, you called me in the middle of the night a couple of weeks ago, and I really only heard the name Jules, so figured I'd ask.
You
well,
didn't hear?
Look, I'm just going to assume she's the reason you're out here. It's an age-old story. And whatever happened, I'm glad because we get to pal around together for a few months. And I'm happy about that.
You do that, lady. I am retracing my steps from yesterday. And by yesterday, I mean like 2 weeks ago now, going by the amount of time that's passed in this game. She's so psyched about me, but we haven't actually spoken, like, ever. So this time around, I'm gonna not take any supplies, because last time I accidentally took supplies. And messed with the story there. That was an accident. If I remember correctly, I was just trying to look at them and inspect them, and he, like, added them to his inventory, or I couldn't put them back in for some reason. And that, made me seem like a bad guy. Well, that's our evacuation point, so I went too far. But hey, we get to take a look at this canyon when it's not on fire. That's pretty sweet. Alright, where are those boxes? I must have walked past them over here. Hello. Are you down here? Am I lost? I really hope I don't get lost. Oh, there it is. We're fine. Hello? Let me guess, what was the password? Could it be? Yep. Might as well just stop locking these now. Let's see. I don't necessarily remember what my base is called. I'm pretty sure it's Two Forks, right? Yep. Report heading home. So I guess I have to do that, don't I? Yep, that's how we end the day.
Alright, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
That's not my name. That's not my name. Oh, there's the fire.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Nope. Have fun. I'm going back inside. I'm going to sleep.
So, no ideas, huh?
No, I'm going to play with my turtle. Look at my turtle. He's adorable. Look at the little guy.
Come on, there's got to be something creative in that brain of yours.
Nope, just turtle.
Yeah.
I guess you're in one of your quiet moods.
Is the shell really that flexible? That can just
How
move
about
like that?
The elk fire. I saw a herd crashing through the timber there a couple of hours ago.
Oopsie.
Okay. The elk fire it is. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is? I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
The bleach is in its base now. Yeah, if I erase the map, I erase the world. Oh no.
Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
It's okay, I've got my fire hat on. Now I'm safe. Got the proper ambience now with no light. Probably, yeah. The objective is literally to talk to her.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
And now she sounds like a pyro. Cool. This'll go great.
I'm glad you're here.
Otherwise, I'd be talking to the rocks. And then where would we be?
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old, dead things it's burning away?
I'm just getting envious of the other lookouts.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Cool. Gonna go fight a bear with a fishing pole. Sounds like a good plan. I got this, bro. I'm gonna save the whole crew. Hello?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it. Thank you, Henry.
Yeah. What the... Dee, I found a clipboard down here, and I, there's something strange going on.
At the lake? What's up?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
They had to have a little bit of mandatory dialogue.
I'm worried.
Otherwise that part wouldn't work. Sprinting into it, headlong, I got this.
Did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
Where are you at, bro? Where are you hiding?
Regardless, just let me know.
I'm ready for you.
Okay, buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
Ow. It's floating. Ow. I'm floating.
Henry? Are you there?
What happened, Henry?
Holy hell, I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. You know, somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
My bad. I was going off in the wrong direction. Forgot about Wapiti.
It seems like a misunderstanding or something. Are you sure you were actually attacked?
How do you be unsure about that?
You've been out here by yourself for a long time.
I'm not even sure how you get unsure about that kind of thing. What you got? Map notes. Just to draw on those nice little path lines. And keep stealing stuff from my apartment. The Fourth Estate. This book is mine now. Oh. Oops, my bad. There we go. Oops. Go on the right. This way. To Wapiti we go. While staring at this creepy purple skull, which lives with me now, and you can't tell me otherwise, this is a dead end. I am a dumb. The other path was the right way to go. Over here? Yep, there's a climbing point. Throw it high! Nope, it fell straight through the world. Alright, well, goodbye forever, book. There's a lot of platforms around here that stuff just falls through. They gotta hire me as a playtester, so I can test all their parts of their game that no one should ever care about anyway. Hello, pile of rocks. Can I pick something up and throw it at you? Knock it all down? Because I will, if I had anything. Mostly because I'm just curious to see if that stuff has physics or not. Is that a pine cone? I'm imagining physical objects. We need more discarded beer. Oh yeah, here's the fence for Wapiti Station. U.S. Code 1683. You can get surprisingly heavy with that. I think I have to dialogue now. There's no objective. Hello. Oh yeah. We can try to do this. And then he just discards stone forever. Take this fence. That wasn't a very good throw at all. You disappoint me, sir. Now we must execute this rock for our sins. Oh, didn't even roll down the hill.
Look, I'm not going to be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Sounds like we're going south, then. It's campfire smoke, that's the scout camp. So we're gonna have to head out and across. Yeah. We need to make it to the lookout camp first before we go much of anywhere else. Should be fine. More running time. Nope, getting stuck on rocks. That's one of those slight immersion breakers, is when you get stuck on a rock like that and you can't go anywhere else. Because you kind of would expect the video game... In real life, you would just hop right off, but in a video game, you gotta walk in a circle around it because you can't jump. It's like, no, the hitboxes! There was a whole lot of that when I was playing The Witness in particular, where I'd run into various objects and I couldn't... Oh, this rope's floating. It bends like it's going around a hitbox, but it's not. Weird. Yeah, in Witness, there was constantly, like, little staircases and tiny ramps that I would have to awkwardly walk all the way around because my character wouldn't be able to clear it. When, of course, they could if they were human.
But they're not. They're robots that doesn't even have parts.
What is all this? Is this supposed to be flowers, I think? I can't quite make out what this is. It almost looks like some kind of fog effect. It's weird. But it's like only right here. I don't know. It looks like weirdly localized fog. Alright. So this is the cleanest way back. Is to head back over here, roughly where we were when we showed up with the fishing pole. Because if we go back the other way... Oh crap, is there a way through here? Yeah, I think there is. No, there's not. I got mixed up about where I was. If I go the other way, we're gonna have to climb up a bunch of rocks and go through the cave again. Which is probably the long way. So we're gonna take this windy road. So we just went right through that windy path right there. So we're gonna head... We're going to Ooh, is that path broken off, though? I might have got myself in a little trouble. I need to go across that path, but I think we may have broken the wire and never repaired it, maybe? No, because I just came here this episode. Let's see here. Because I came here with the fishing line, so I must be in the area. So you keep trying to head east. Southeast-ish. He keeps wanting to talk about being east of the lake. Surely I can climb up this, right? Yeah, there's a rope now. Yeah, my character started off roughly around here this episode.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Oops. Did not successfully grab rope. There we go.
Take this, physics engine.
I just thought you'd like to know that. To repeat, this is just happening to you and me. There's got to be a reasonable explanation for all of this.
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
I am going to continually frustrate and irritate her. All right, so we are now right there, in the middle of the screen there. We just climbed up that spot. And now we're going to go down this way. Alright, so we'll keep heading vaguely south, but mostly east. Cool, I can run with the compass out. So we're going to take the lowest path possible as far as going southerly goes. And we'll have a path... Oop! Where's that go? Oh yeah, that'll take me towards the medicine ball. That's fine. Medicine wheel, I mean.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
Now he's talking about Brian Goodwin. The irony is very thick there. Alright, here's our path across.
Anyway, I don't expect you to care as much about it. And I'm probably just working myself up into a tizzy over nothing. Sorry, we just need to focus on what's happening to us.
I managed to take a completely different path this time. I came here right around this time last time, too, but I didn't take this path to get here. Three blind rats. Yeah, last time when I came through here, I took the other path in, had to go kind of... I think I had to hop across rocks a little bit in the river. Then I went this way and it was a dead end and it was kind of a waste of time. So I was more organic this time on accident. There's the weird ski on the tree. Oh, wow. With that tree on that hill, with that sun in this corner, anyone else thinking of witness right now? Pew! That is a really good photo, actually. I'm happy with that one. There we go. Gonna try to remember to fill up the camera as much as I can along the way. With decent shots here and there. Just because last time I was really disappointed when I realized that I'd gone the entire playthrough and left it. That made me sad. Here's the weird jet skis. Hello. Just gonna put that on there. Oh, it fell through. Not what I was going for. There we go. Boom. I'm a regular Max Caulfield. Mine. I'm gonna get you, scouts. I'm going to a scout camp as a grown adult wearing shorts. This'll go over well. Camp Arapaho. You think that the guy who brought his kid out here could have just brought their kid here instead. But instead they didn't. Instead, other things happened. Oh, that's broken. We need to find our alternate way in. I think those rocks are involved. Right up here. Yep. Yep. Ooh. It's a nice little overpass. I guess this place might have been fully abandoned already by then. Not sure what the timeline here was. It's just called an old shelter now. Bloop. There we go. 9 shots to go. Gotta save a few for the future days. Okay, those firemen are gone, though. This axe is mine now. This will come in handy. Welcome to the Castlevania element of this game.
Hey, D, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
We'll never know. I guess we should just give up.
I mean, you and I aren't very interesting.
Speak for yourself.
Well,
in fact, I'll speak
for
you.
Not. I'm infinitely complex.
God damn it, she's saying the same thing back at me.
But
no, I won. I did it first.
Us? How could they let them do that? Study people who sign up to watch fires? How?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
I'm taking this book back with me, damn it. There's probably really specific paths you could take throughout the entire world to take every...
Hey there. I had a thought.
...individual book back with
you. Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck. There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
No, I was collecting books. Tragedy has stricken.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The elk fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
Answer my radio, and then I just don't respond to her. Did I take the book back with me, or did I dump it on the ground? Oh, I don't see it here, I don't think. That's a bummer. Hey, sweet old guy.
Isn't this just the most beautiful day? What a glorious day we've been given. Well, I suppose I should get back to work. The elk fire is becoming quite the problem. By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Let me look at it, and I'll tell you.
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
All right. Cottonwood. 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 Am I missing some? Did I miss the little spot? Cottonwood Creek, that right down there. Right where I just was. Alright, south we go. Enjoy your toilet paper, turtle. I love you. And out we go. Oh, fire is getting worse. Noticeably worse. Makes you regret being in a tower, huh? Where all the smoke rises, too. Just continually getting into a worse situation for breathing. Alright, so we want to go south, actually. And that'll be how we get to Cottonwood. Right, we have to find that one... We have to find the lockbox there that I found earlier. Because that's where she put the new stuff. Let's see. I'm going to want to go to the medicine... Specifically, I want to go to the medicine wheel. Because if I could just go straight south from there, we're right at my objective. Then we've got it nailed. So I'm noticing that there's a few scenes they use along the way very carefully to make sure that certain pieces of information get communicated to our friend here, Delilah, even if you aren't talking to her actively. Like, they specifically, like, the name Jules gets told to her through that little dream sequence thing where you're kind of incoherent. No matter what you do. Even though she doesn't know anything about Jules as far as, like, what's going on with her. See, which way am I facing right now? West, south. Maybe a little off from where I was trying to go. I'm sure I got this. Yep, there's the medicine wheel. So we're good to go. So yeah, they definitely have a few pieces of mandatory dialogue. Sometimes you have to trigger it yourself, and sometimes it just kind of happens, whether you're pressing buttons or not. But it leads to certain things happening so that she can use the word jewels in conversation and stuff like that without it being a weird contradiction of your experience up to that point. Kind of makes me wonder what would happen, though, in real life if somebody just never answered the phone. Because obviously I have. Oh, crap. I forgot the code. Alright. Was it 6789? It is not. Alright. I'm gonna have to... ask her.
Hey, I'm here and I found a cash box that does not open with 1234.
It's because I changed it. It's 5678.
That was close.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
There we go. My bad.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
Things are escalating in creepy fashion.
Whatever these people are doing is illegal, right? We need to find out how they're doing it, why, everything. You understand? Henry? Just call me when you get there.
I'm just waiting for her to freak out as I continue to ignore her in an increasingly tense situation. I got stuck on a tree. Oh, then I kind of walked over it.
Hey, I just thought of something not great.
I ignore her and she just doesn't bring it up. She just does not at all mention what was not great about it. Interesting. There we go. Well, onward. I know where I'm going. I wonder if I can hide important information that I find in this next area from her. Because there's some pretty freaky stuff in the next room that really feeds into both of us getting hysterical about the whole situation. But if I just don't tell her, then, I mean, she doesn't know, right? It all depends on if the dialogue's mandatory. So here's where we first saw evidence of the campers. And then I ran by and trashed their stuff. Here we go. Yeah, I'm starting to really memorize the map of this area. I guess it's just not that big, so you figure it out relatively quickly. But I've very rarely looked at my map in this playthrough, and a lot of times it's not even because I need to, but just because I feel like showing you guys vague ideas of where we're going. There's the other lockbox, so there should be a path right up here. What's this stuff supposed to be? Pollen, maybe? And honestly, there's a bunch of giant, like, hairy ghost pears flying around. Which is a weird thought. Here we go.
You will be mine one day, silly rock formation.
Just need something to throw at them. Yeah, her conversation earlier about getting lost in the fire just makes it feel like she's just obsessed with fires and super into it. Wow. Kind of thought that he would just bust the lock, but he pried the gate open around the lock. Hello? See, I have clairvoyance now, and I'm not opening that thing because a bee's gonna sting me, and I don't want to get stung today. So take that, bee. You live in there forever now. You're never getting out. You're gonna starve to death in there. To death. Wow, I'm jonesing for Mass Effect, aren't I? The color changes as you come through here are amazing. Look at that. All the sun, the entire horizon darkens into a stark silhouette over there. As you have a blood red sun. There's so many nice little details here. Hello, soil grid for geologic survey purposes generally. This is the kind of stuff that I could have potentially done if anyone hired me. Yay, life sucks. The end. Hello? You look awfully important. Just having a little fun with it. There it is, skewed perception of personal history. That's what I was talking about with Delilah.
Are you shitting me?
What? What is it?
There's a folder of reports here.
What do they say?
They're assessments about the two of us. It says things about my life. Stuff you don't know.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you. This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
You have a boyfriend, Javier?
What the fuck?
Wish you hadn't left that out.
I don't. I didn't. This is insane. I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it. Worst case scenario... Worst case scenario, I guess. A bunch of people die. Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, it's definitely not the best idea.
Ah, so fucking wound up!
See, she's trying to pretend Javier doesn't exist.
Anyway, I'm sure you are too. Get the hell out of there if you're not already, and call me when you get home. I don't know what the hell we're gonna do.
Oh, I have to walk back, my bad. For some reason, I thought they're gonna be like, what the hell is going on? Then have like a dramatic cutaway. Alright, well, this mug is coming with me for a while, because I don't love Wyoming, but you love Wyoming. Keep stopping when I run. Probably hitting some kind of invisible stamina limit. Or maybe the key is cutting out on my keyboard. Who knows? Using regular-ass keyboards, PC players probably just destroy these things over time.
Whoa! Whoa! Oh, shit!
I still have my mug. This is silly.
Henry? I think there is smoke coming from north of Jonesy Lake. That is suspiciously close to where you just were. Do you see it?
Nope, don't see nothing. You ain't getting me, copper.
Henry!
Na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. La-la-la, can't hear you.
It's burning like hell over there. Tell me you did not start it.
Na-na-na. Quiet. Nope, no one sees the fire. There's no fire. Oh, well, I can't take this uphill.
Tell me you did not start it. Holy shit. What if you did? Calm down, Delilah. That's crazy. Of course he didn't do that. He wouldn't do that. Would he, Henry? The hell do I do? You know what? Screw it. I'm leaving it and we'll see what happens. And I'm gonna try to get us out of here by... Well, I'm gonna try. Over and out.
Now she's losing her mind. Uh-oh. He's our fun little piece of crazy. She doesn't need to know what I'm up to. It can be all you and me.
Are you leaving your lookout?
This receiver picked something up. I'm just checking it out.
What thingy? What now?
I found a device that picks up frequencies. It's how I found the reports last night, and it's going off now.
It just picked up a frequency?
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of vodka?
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Yeah.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
All right, have fun getting drunk.
But you... You better stay sober. We need a right mind between the pair. Know what I'm saying? My thinking is I could stay up all night worried I'm gonna lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is I'm gonna follow this wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are.
Shit! What?
It's a trap.
Ah.
It's a trap. I've been trapped. They know everything now. And now I've got a special lock. Do I have to report the backpack? Just to examine it. Oh, did I not finish examining it yet?
What are you doing over there?
You don't need to know. It's fine.
Hello? If that thing is driving you crazy, just turn it off or throw it away. Or just pace around your tower like you are right now.
I'm not at my tower.
Henry, you're freaking me out. Henry?
That's freaky. I don't reveal to her at all that I'm not the one at my tower right now. So she just doesn't know that someone else is there right now. What if that was the trick to catching the guy that's there? Is he don't talk to her? Because wasn't he? I think he was listening to the new frequencies too, wasn't he? What, like this didn't actually solve anything? She's not in a good mood now. I'm accepting zero blame.
Just burn the place down. Think about it. Just burn the place down.
Whoa, the whiskey's flying.
No, it's not because I'm hungover. Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
I'm sure I don't seem like a crazy person right now at all, with my flying vodka. OCD Simulator 2016. That's a messed up joke. But I'm not taking it back. Alright, we're going down to the cave now.
For the big reveals.
How many shots do I have in my camera now? Let's see, I'm sure I'm going the wrong way right now. Yeah, we're going... Oh, no, north is the right way. The fire's in the other direction. We'll have plenty to take pictures of now, though. How many do I have? 9. Bloop. It's quite a bit of smoke now. Really, it's probably a good idea to go down to the ravine to get out of it a little bit. Actually, no, I don't know. Maybe the heavy smoke kind of gathers down there. Might create a thorough, like, funneling effect to some extent that makes a mess of things. Maybe. But yeah, I think to some extent you're meant to take some pictures when you find the good ones.
You didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout. It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kind of just wish I hadn't.
I'm just gonna let it fuck with her. Yay! We're horrible people. I should not go down there unless I want the radio to run out, though.
You know, I'm just freaking out. I'm alright.
Oh, she's over it? Alright. Fine.
Yep.
Is the antler still here? Sure is. Kind of spawned in just now. Well, now I have the key. Boop. I just like being able to take pictures in games sometimes. This horn is mine now, and it's coming with me.
Jesus, this is a big cave.
Well, he didn't react very much to that, did he? Oh, we gotta use the Pulaski. Bam. Yeah, that seems safe. We'll just squeeze on through there with my horn. Oopsie. Oh, crap, I dropped it. Didn't get a chance to grab it back. Eh, we'll be back later. It's fine. Let's go get our climbing supplies. In our survival horror cave. That's a cool angle, by the way. The realization of how huge this place is kind of a cool moment in this game.
It's freezing in here.
They made a kind of huge cave environment. Hello. Dun, dun, dun.
And that was where the shoe was lost.
I remember at this point I was still losing my mind a little bit about what it was and wasn't real in this game, because I was... Probably because I just recently played Soma, I was expecting something completely nuts to happen. And so when I saw the corpse, I thought that might have been Delilah's corpse. Like, she was never alive this entire time. And I've been losing my mind and imagining conversations with some person that has only ever existed before I got here. and all that little bits of darkness. Yep. There we go. She doesn't need to know. It's fine. Onward. So the good ones were staying right, yep, right over here. Look at that. Look at Goodwin Castle. Not gonna feel bad about this at all afterwards. Alright. We're gonna need those. There we go. Can't take this with you. Be free, video games! That didn't go very far at all. Well, it lives there now. Then we have the diagrams of what he was inventing, and his little cute D&D stuff. And of course, his note to the ranger. Because he wanted to tell the park rangers about the fact that, I can put these back up, can I? Yeah. They wanted to have their little note to the, the park rangers about why the, items were there, because he stole that stuff from his dad, because his dad was freaking him out. And he didn't want to get in trouble anymore, but he didn't want to go climbing, because he thought that they were going to... I mean, he rightfully thought that his dad was putting him in danger. And we know where it went from there. And if you don't know where it went from there, you should have not been watching this version of the playthrough yet. Dummy. I warned you, like, repeatedly. Take that, dinosaur. Mankind rules supreme. There we go. So many little objects you can just take. You know what? This dinosaur is going on a journey. Can I pose this dinosaur? Like, really carefully? That's what I meant. Good job. Let's just take the dinosaur with me a little bit. Can I walk around with it? You have to hold it out like that. I want to...
So, something I never told you, or anyone, about Brian.
Oh, there it goes.
In regards to him being out here, you know, being against the rules. They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and... I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied. And just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
Well, you certainly saved him from life with Ned. If it's any consolation. And that's about it. It's okay, you're just kind of a monster.
What do you think is in there?
Do you really want to know? Do you really want to know?
Well, let me know before you go back in, okay?
Nope. That's not what kind of playthrough this is. Where am I right now, though? I'm sure I'll reckon...
Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
So they were never truly missing. They were just being dicks to their parents, as teenagers do. The end.
So there's some good news for us. For whatever it's worth.
A game that's all about being the non-story. A lot of people have been really mad about the story of this game. And a lot of people were cool with it. With the way that it kind of goes back on the premise a bit. Asshole tried to lock me in here. First of all, why did he... I guess he tried to lock me in here because he was trying to hide the secret of what happened. But he must have known there was a way out. It was only going to get more of a... become more of a trap for them at that point. Oops, that's not a... That's not what I was going for. There we go. Onward. Let's get my antlers real quick. There we go. I believe in you. Hey, they actually made it down. We did it. Seem to be having a few frame rate issues. I wonder if it's because it has to load the entire cave all at once. That I was otherwise not loading to save on performance. The game does get away with having no loading bars aside from when it changes days. Oh yes, here it comes. Our biggest, saddest reveal. Exactly what happened. You have to click to step over it, but my antler. There we go. Its head's even covered in rocks. So even if you lived to the fall, he probably...
You fell. Your stuff gave out. Oh, you poor fucking kid.
One photo to go. Yep, there's our last sad reveal. Now it's time to burn it all down. It is an effective game. I'm being slightly dismissive of it now only because of the fact that I've experienced it already, of course, but... It's the whole point of here is just to see Delilah's reactions and stuff when I don't talk to her. Because like I said at the beginning of this session, this is a game you can only experience for the first time once. So I generally recommend, whenever people talk about this game, I generally just recommend to them to just go ahead and just go buy it, just play it. It's worth experiencing it yourself the first time. I can't take the horn with me. I genuinely think it's worth a go to just experience this on your own. Just like the Telltale games and all that. There's certain story-driven things where there's a... It's more personal when you do it, because you make there's all those little touches that are specific to the way that you reacted to things. Because while this whole genre is kind of famous for not having big sweeping changes in the story, you do still constantly impact really minor details all the time that make the story feel personal to you. And that's why it's worth it. Oh yeah, reporting the body's mandatory, isn't it? I don't think I can get away with not telling her about the body that the entire game is building up to finding. I could try running back to the base though, just see if I get away with it. It won't take too long. They probably made the right call by usually not requiring you to go all the way back to base each time. Because it's a bit of a trek to make each time just to end your day. So usually the days just end at a sudden jump cut to a loading screen, then you're back at base again, or elsewhere. Yeah, I don't think this is gonna work. At the very least, I would presume that when you get back into your tower, that she'd probably react to that in some capacity. She'd probably see you back on the tower and then be asking questions. Maybe. I don't know. We can test it. There's the sound of my generator. No reaction. I'm back. Floating whiskey. That's the biggest mystery of them all.
Hey, D.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Brian Goodwin is dead. His body is the only thing I found in the cave.
What?
He's dead, Dee.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm. He just left him out here. He left his son.
What do we do now, Dee? I mean, are you okay?
No, I'm not. He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Those are my notes. Did I really pick up that many objects? I guess a lot of them were at Brian Goodwin's place. They're all gone now.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Is this the Elk Fire or the Site Fire or...
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec? You know, about things?
About what?
About forced burns. It's okay, everybody. I took the turtle. He's safe.
Believe it or not, I'm out of things to say.
Hey, do you hear that?
Yeah, Jesus. Beep, beep.
So what do we do?
I think you follow it, Henry.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I'll remember you? Jeez. I don't think that's quite as extreme as he was going for at that moment. Alright, I'm leaving Forrest Burns because it's going to be a pain in the ass to run around with him on my character. Is the game chugging a little bit? It shouldn't be on the system. I wonder if it's just because I'm running and it has to load various things. Alright, we gotta hustle, even though it means running through smoke, which is probably really screwing with our breathing and probably making it really hard to do this.
What's your status?
She just thinks I'm dead. She leaves without me.
With the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
This is gonna be a long run, actually. I have to make my way all the way to the lake, which is where the secret base was. Where we got caught that one time. Oh no, never mind, is this it right here? Yep.
Flip. I kind of get why Brian took to her. about you finding anything out. And that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids, all right? Nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him, all right? We were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions, and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
And now we've got the tape. Got evidence about what happened, the stuff he was stealing from people's campsites, because that's how he was getting by a lot of time, was by scavenging things. I wonder if I just leave. She didn't want to talk about it at this point. Howard Crothers Stevens' room. Yep, and there's his view of my campsite right there. That is a bone. A bunch of utensils, a couple tools, and a bone. Alright, I believe it's time for us to go. Let's pick up his clothes. He got the hell out of here real fast. Don't think I can go anywhere else besides right back the way I came from, right? Alright. We'll just try to avoid reporting it for a while and see if something automatically triggers, because I don't think there's any roadblocks for walking around. The whole point of this is to try to experiment with how you don't talk to her, after all. Here we go. I believe we just go back down the way we came. This turns into a really short playthrough when you're not examining stuff all the time. I think we've been at it for about 2 hours now. Which is a surprise. How did I get here again? Oh yeah, there's his campsite. So I want to head... yeah, north a bit, basically. Yeah? Let's go ahead and visit the lake. Actually, no. If I head back west, then we can just, we can just climb up back up the slope I just climbed, go by the tower. And that's actually probably the shortest path back to the beginning. There's something oddly dark about just not reporting to her what I found just now. Here we go. We'll see if we can get away with it. She didn't really want to talk about it either, because she's all beaten down by the revelation of what happened to the boy. But despite that, I'd be surprised if you can get away with just not telling her at all. Here we go. So we're going to want to head... yep. Just go roughly straight from here until we get the ability to go rappelling. The helicopter's our way out of here. Alright, heading east.
Henry? Henry, what did you find?
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
Henry, hello? Come on, I'm sick over here.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. He's deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
He's got a survival bunker with radios and everything. He made it all up.
You need to get back here They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole. I wish you were as mad as I am. I wish I had a minute with Ned and a 357 Magnum. Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it. Henry? Are you even there? Hello?
Dee?
There you are. Oh, fuck, they're here.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
I'm practically there, too. They could just wait a little bit longer.
Hike safe.
Assholes. Yeah, they're gonna come back, I think. That's encouraging. Interesting that if I'm all talkative about it, she doesn't want to talk about it at all, and she's super, like, withdrawn about the whole thing for understandable reasons. But then when you give her a when she is exposed to a vacuum, and you're not responding, then suddenly she's constantly saying things, and then asking where you are if you don't respond to the old outhouse. There's that broken down house. Alright. Don't want to get too mixed up about where I'm going here. It is hard to see stuff around here now. There's the wire that we followed. That was a pretty good, it was actually a fitting point that, that the father made when he was talking about how she is a record that you don't have to flip. Because she does just keep talking. She carries the whole game by just talking nonstop. Alright, I think we're almost there. Just about. It is kind of cool being able to navigate the full environment again, but having it all in this orange haze. Wonder if any players ever go south just to see what it looks like down there. I'm sure you have access to it. Unless the character freaks out like, no, we can't go that way, we gotta live. Oh crap, am I getting mixed up here? The wires, oh no, it looks like I might go up here and then back down? No? Crap, I'm at the wires. Did I go too far in the wrong direction? Or do I have to loop around this way? Maybe. Oh yeah, it looks like I do. I have to loop back past them. This should be the right way now. Am I going north again? Southwest. No. Oh no. Well, I should be going sort of southwest. Wow. Big ol' marker is saying where to go at that point, huh? I'm sure I'll find my way back somewhere. West. Here we go. This is the part where the two paths merge, and we're about to come up on the supply drop. There's no follow-up on the fact that I didn't take anything. Or I didn't take everything. I guess that's fitting. The follow-up would only happen if I stole stuff, because they're like, why'd you do that? But otherwise, why would they call me about it again? There's the cable car. And so we say goodbye after 2 hours to this entire area. This is the part where it's supposed to feel really ominous because you're trying to call Delilah and she's not responding because she's not on the radio in range or something. And you're wondering if they're going to leave you behind and you're going to die or something. That's a nice sight. This is Delilah's tower. Yeah, I think the first time I saw it, I thought it was collapsed. Because the first bit of staircase looks destroyed. Alright. There's the drawing of me. Nope. I'll keep that, though. There's her tequila. Her apple. So that's how she drew me this time, based on basically no information. Someone kind of rude and lonely. I'm wearing the bowling shirt, like she mentioned. Shorts, white. What we know, short and whites. Oh yeah. No mention of the turtle, because I never told her about the turtle, so she just doesn't know it exists. Now it's mine. There's the radio, a few other little pieces here.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Well, now I'm definitely not talking to you.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah. Me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe...
typewriter to good use. If you ever decide to write about this, I'd really appreciate it if you gave me a sexy accent or something that, you know, would play well in the movie version.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
Maybe get a dog?
Hold on. Let me write all this down.
Whenever the season's about to wrap up, I usually find myself thinking, and when I get back, I'm gonna call him. You know, casual, and just see how he's doing. I'll say something like, hey, I had a dream about you this summer and thought I'd call. You know, something that lets him know that I want him without letting him know I want him. Yeah. Whatever you do, don't do that.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
She continues to be a piece of work, huh?
Bye, Hank.
You both come off as a little dysfunctional if you're not talking to her. It kind of, at some points, it kind of feels like, well, those clips where you see Two and a Half Men or Big Bang Theory, where they cut out the laugh track, so everyone just keeps pausing after every bit of conversation. And staring at each other for a few seconds. Can't even imagine how awkward it is to actually film those shows where everyone has to stop for a few seconds for an imaginary laugh track no one can actually hear. There we have it, guys. That was Firewatch for the second time. This time around, to remind you that the goal was to play the entire game, doing as little dialogue as possible, just to see what impact it has. Mostly leads to a lot of awkward pauses where someone turns around and reacts to me being an asshole, kind of. Now we got to see my photos. They play in reverse order, so there's his hideaway, there's the fall, the corpse that fell that height, a discarded dinosaur toy from the dead boy, and his little fantasy world. His shoe. What happy photos we got here in this infinite cave. That antler did not actually make it very far, come to think of it, because it started out just outside that cave. The smoky hill. A few pieces of the camp. Some really scenic stuff around there. The weird use of jet ski. And the witness tree. It very much reminds me of the witness. My turtle, before I covered it in random stuff and floating alcohol. Creeper cam inside of my place. The elk fire. She named it elk that time around. Because I didn't name it. My trusty guitar. I tried so hard to make it keep going. There's a lot of names in there I just noticed that I kind of recognize. No trespassing. The accidental photo of my own face. And then sadness. There's the dinosaur again. Yep. You found out real hard why you're not supposed to have kids there. Alright guys, so this has been a Patreon-sponsored video for Jesse Miller. If you want to find out how to sponsor videos and be able to say, hey, play this game for an hour and stuff like that, or in his case, multiple hours, because he's had some credits stocked up over time, you can go to patreon.com/SebastianSB. Thanks for watching, like always, guys. The link is in the description. I will see you next time, and thank you very much, Jesse Miller, for your support.